Other than a brief jump in the polls after he executed his revenge on Julia Gillard, Kevin Rudd has been hurtling towards defeat. Barring a minor miracle by tomorrow night, his second stint as Prime Minister will be over. Still, he's fighting to the bitter end, and he spoke with our political editor Hugh Riminton just a few moments ago.
Prime Minister, thank you for joining us. Will you win the election tomorrow?
Hugh, I believe we can win the election. And as I've travelled around the country in the last day or two, I sense the pennies beginning to drop with many Australians as to what Mr Abbott's massive cuts will mean for their jobs, their job security, their penalty rates, their overtime, their schools, their hospitals, their broadband and their cost of living pressures. And ultimately, an election is about choices.
Why are you continuing with the line that Tony Abbott is all about cuts when his costings document that came out yesterday indicates, if anything, they're not going to be fiscally all that tough? In fact, they're not going to bring the budget back to surplus really any deal sooner than you would do?
Well, the bottom line, Hugh, is this. If Mr Abbott was being completely upfront and open with the Australian people about what he's talked about for years, that is his massive cuts, then why wouldn't he produce all of his detailed documentation much earlier in the campaign? It's been kept secret until the very last moment, and that's for a good purpose. Even, however, Hugh, from what we know, there's an $8 billion cut to the Better Schools Plan for education. There is a $5 billion cut in terms of tax benefits to small business. There's a $4 billion cut to the school kids bonus, $8 billion cut to infrastructure. And that's just the beginning before you get on to the cuts which affect, for example, self-funded retirees and part pensioners and the impact on their investment income of his quite extraordinary paid parental leave scheme for millionaires.
Kevin Rudd, just briefly, was it worth it returning to the Prime Ministership?
What is worthwhile, Hugh, is out there fighting for the jobs of those watching your news program tonight and their hard-gained penalty rates over time and working conditions, and to fight for the funding for their schools and their hospitals, their broadband and their childcare. They, the people of Australia, will ultimately decide, but my message to all Australians tonight is very simple. If after 20 years in Parliament and five weeks of an election campaign, if on the day before Election Day you still have doubts about how Mr Abbott's massive cuts would affect your jobs and job security, your hospitals and schools, then don't vote for him. It's as simple as that.
Mr Rudd, thank you for your time this afternoon and in a bipartisan sense, good luck for tomorrow.
Thanks very much, Hugh.
Of course, it's only fair we give Tony Abbott equal time, and he joins me now from Penrith. Mr Abbott, you spent a lot of time in Sydney's West over the past 5 weeks, and if everything we hear is right, you have to thank the good people there for making you Prime Minister tomorrow.
Sandra, this election is still anyone's to win. That's why I'm out here at Penrith, at the Panthers, to say to the people of Western Sydney, if you want to scrap the carbon tax, if you want to end the waste, if you want to stop the boats, and if you want to get WestConnex built, you've got to vote for the coalition for Liberal candidates in the House and in the Senate.
Well, if you do win tomorrow, can you clarify on election eve that you will follow tradition and make the lodge your place of residence?
The point I've made is that I will be an orthodox Prime Minister because I want to lead an adult, grown-up government. And that's why I think Australia can't have another 3 years like the last six, because I don't believe we have always had an adult, grown-up government over the last 6 years.
Back to the question, though. Will Kirribilli be your residence once the lodge is renovated, or where will you call home?
There's an election to win. It's like a grand final with 2 minutes to go. Either side can win with a converted try. My job is to take it down to the wire, reminding people that if you want a new way, you've got to have a new government. If you want to stop the boats and end the waste and scrap the carbon tax, you've got to vote for the coalition tomorrow.
Sure, but if you win tomorrow, will you reside in Sydney? The people of New South Wales might want to know.
Well, you're asking me to speculate, Sandra. I've spent most of my life in Sydney. I've spent most of my life in Sydney. I am a Sydney-sider through and through. I'm also conscious of the fact that if I do become Prime Minister, I have to represent all Australians, country and city, New South Wales, Victorian, Western Australian, etc. You've got to be a Prime Minister for everyone. And I think, again, this is one of the reasons why we need to change the government, because neither Mr Rudd nor Ms Gillard have been above trying to divide Australians, and that's very much the wrong way to go.
Tony Abbott, we thank you for your time and wish you and Kevin Rudd all the best tomorrow.
Thank you so much, Sandra.
Hugh joins us on the desk now. Hugh, just one double-barrelled question. Who wins and by how much?
And the standard answer is nearly 15 million Australians will make their minds up tomorrow and give us that answer. The reality is that the polls are not great for Labor at all. There was a poll today, as we heard from Paul Bongiorno, a Lonergan Guardian poll, indicating a slight move back to Labor, about 51-49. It's still the coalition's way. The reality of minority government is for Labor to retain government, it needs a net swing towards it. And there is nothing in any of the polls which indicates that that is on the cards. One thing we have to watch tomorrow night is the state of the Senate. The reason for that is if there is a coalition win tomorrow, Tony Abbott has made plain he wants to get rid of the carbon tax. If the Senate looks to resist him, because the numbers are there in the Senate to do that, he has already made clear he's happy to go to another double dissolution election, possibly within 12 months, to win that fight over the carbon tax. If the polls are right and Labor's gone, they have a lot of soul-searching to do. How do they rebuild the brand? How do they bind up their wounds? And importantly, who will lead them as they head off into the wilderness?
Well, my friend, just on 24 hours to go, we'll be back here tomorrow night.
We will be.
Going through the numbers. Thank you.
Thank you.